हाउ टू कन्वर्ट इथाइल बेंजीन इंटू टू फिनाइल प्रोपेनोइक एसिड। लेट्स स्टार्ट। द एन ब्रोमोसक्सिनेमाइड रिएजेंट इज एड इंटू इथाइल बेंजीन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ लाइट और हाई टेम्परेचर और रेडिकल इनिशिएटर लाइक पेरोक्साइड, देन वी गेट द प्रोडक्ट which contain bromine at allylic position. Okay, and this product is 1-bromo-1-phenyl-ethane. And this reaction is called bromination reaction. Okay, how NBS work in this reaction? See, now NBS is called N-bromosuccinamide. Okay, the structure of NBS is that, okay, NBS is frequently used to brominate allylic or benzylic position because it allow radical substitution mechanism without subjecting reactant. In simple word, due to N-bromosuccinamide in reaction, it will not produce the high concentration of Br2 and HBr that could be added to double bond. Okay. Now, this is the main advantage of this reaction. Discuss about the mechanism of this reaction. First step, in the presence of light or high temperature or radical initiator like peroxide, the homolytic bond cleavage take place. Okay, the electron will distribute equally in both of them. That means the electron, both atom have 1-1 electron. Now, this is the initiation step in which the nitrogen and Br bond homolytically break. In the presence of light, it will generate the bromine radical. In propagation step, bromine radical will abstract benzylic hydrogen and produce benzylic radical and hydrogen bromide. This is the step one. It is the rate determining step of overall reaction. Okay, because here this intermediate generate. Okay. In second step, this benzyl radical extract bromine from Br2 and we get benzylic bromide and propagating bromine radical. This bromine radical will extract hydrogen from other ethyl benzene and this reaction will repeat over and over. Okay, that's why this reaction called radical chain reaction. Okay, during the reaction HBr is also produced. Now the homolytic cleavage of this both compound and what and we get, see, we get amide and Br2, and this Br2 use in to generate new bromine radical. Okay. That's why concentration of Br2 and HBr is under controlled. when we add NaCN in this alkyl bromide, then the substitution reaction will take place. Now see how CN minus is strong nucleophile. The carbon will attack this carbon, and bromine is good leaving group, it will be removed. That's why this is called substitution reaction. One group is added and second group is removed at same carbon. In this product, one carbon is more. The carbon-carbon bond formed and carbon-bromine bond break. Nitrile is even harder to hydrolyze than amide. Nitrile slowly hydrolyzed in carboxylic acid when heated with water and acid at high temperature. HCl amount is catalytic amount. Okay, that means we use HCl at minor amount. Okay. Ammonia will be released. Here carbon nitrogen bond break, and here carbon oxygen bond form 2-phenyl propanoic acid. We can get our desired product in 3 steps. First step is, second one is, third step is